We are here.
Such a stranger lately.
Hello, Anthony.
Long time.
Long time. I need a haircut.
You look like what? Get in here. So I can look at you. Never seen such ratty hair on a human.
Woke up this morning and knew it was time.
You knew where to come.
I said to myself, I want a haircut.
Maybe you want to eat something, Foist.
You could eat something?
Huh. I have takeout in the fridge that I nibble at it when I get the urge. That woman.
That's right.
That her family's got like money, unbeknownst. Never thought you'd get married so young, but what do I know? I have chickpea all mashed up, and I have eggplant with rice and nuts.
Give me the eggplant.
Oh, good. Your father did not tell your mother until he had to. He went fast once they found it. He was diagnosed and then he went. You was 4 years old.
Five.
Exactly.
And you? You keep him well?
You know me, kid. I could tell you I can't complain. But I could definitely complain. The thing is, I don't wanna, cause ain't time. Let me think what I have that we could drink. Water from the tap. I drink water now. I have a bottle of liqueur that's been here, don't ask how long.
I could drink some of that.
Because if your father himself walked in here and I offered him tap water, oh, God forbid, he would rip out my last hair.
Well, maybe we could ask my driver to come in. My driver's outside in the car.
Oh, we could give him the other eggplant. Drove a checkered cab. Big, bouncy. I drove nights. I was young. What could they do to me?
Nights is not so good if you have a wife and child. Besides, I could tell you, it was crazy enough in the daytime.
I loved my cab. I drove 12 hours nonstop. I stopped only to pee.
A man is hit one day by another taxi. Comes flying into my taxi. I mean, he was flying in the air. Crash against the windscreen. Right there in my face. Blood is everywhere.
I never left my garage without my Windex.
I am acting secretary of external affairs in my previous life. I said to him, get out from there. I cannot drive with your buddy on my windscreen.
I ate at the wheel. I kept my sandwiches and tinfoil.
I ate at the wheel also. I could not afford to stop driving.
Where did you pee, Ibrahim? I peed under the Manhattan Bridge.
This is where I peed exactly.
I peed in parks and alleys. I peed in a pet cemetery once.
Nights is better in some ways. I am certain of it.
I was here, what, probably 4 hours a day, helping my father cut hair. Nights, I drove my cab. Oh, I love my cab. I had a little fan that worked on a battery because air conditioning. Forget about it in that day and age. And then I had a drinking cup with a magnet that I stuck on a dashboard.
I had my steering wheel upholstered, very nice, in zebra, and my daughter with a photograph on the visor.
I gave this guy his foist haircut. He didn't want to sit in the car seat. His father tried to jam him in there. He was going, no, 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 no. And so I put him right where he's sitting now. His father pinned him down. I cut his father's hair when he was a kid. Then I cut his hair.
But where is the chief of security in this situation? I realize he's not with us. We are alone.
I gave him the rest of the night off.
You have protection, right, in the car?
Protection.
Protection. You know what that means?
I had a gun, but I threw it away.
But why?
I didn't want to make plans. I wasn't thinking ahead. Didn't want to take precautions.
You know how that sounds. How does that sound? I thought you were some kind of big shot. You know, destroyed people in the blink of an eye. Huh? But you sound pretty iffy to me. This is Mike Backer's kid. Dad had a gun and threw it away? What is that?
Yes, what is that?
Yeah, in this part of town, and you had a gun. Huh?
There are steps you must take to safeguard yourself.
In this part of town?
You cannot walk 5 meters after dark. You'll be careless. They kill you straight away. You'll be reasonable with them. They take a little longer. Tear out your entrails first.
What happened to your eye that it got all twisted that way?
I can see. I can drive. I passed their test.
You were beaten and tortured. An army coup. On the secret police. Or they thought they'd executed you. Fired a shot into your face. Left you for dead.
I loved my cab. I gulped my food. I drove 12 hours straight, night after night. Vacations, forget about. But what did I do for protection?
I need to leave.
How come?
I don't know how come. That's how come.
But let me do the left side at least, so both sides are equal.
I'll come back. Take my word for it. I'll sit, and you'll finish.